evening's program, as you can see, is divided into three sections. And I've done that for a couple of reasons. I've done several concerts in the past here at Harbin, and because I'm so relaxed during the day, this is kind of a reverse role for me of being on the spot on performance. And I tend to tense up a little over a 90-minute period, so I like to have a few little breaks in there, and I think everybody else would appreciate that too. It is a lot of guitar music for 90 minutes. And a couple of things can happen during those breaks. Some of you will want to leave, obviously, and had enough, and some of you will want to go up and tell your friends to come on back down because there's a great concert happening in the temple, so that would be cool too. Also, you'll be hearing some music during these breaks, and I've just selected a few tracks from a collection of recordings that I've made over the past years. And all of these things that you hear are available on CDs over to my left during the course of the evening. If you would like to have a CD, you're welcome to them. They're all by donation. And also there's obviously a donation bowl by the door. And being that this is the small compensation that we artists receive for performing for you here at Harbin, any help that you can give us is very much appreciated. So thank you for that. So without really getting into a lot of chatter about things, I have a lot of music I'd like to play for you, and I'd like to get started. The first segment is early music from the Baroque and Renaissance periods. And this is music for Sunday evening, so I've kind of kept some, a bit low key. There's a few fireballs in there, and I'll start off a little big, and then we'll settle into some things. So I hope you enjoy tonight's program. This is Lady Hunsdon's Galliard. 16th century England, John Dowland. Welcome. Thank you. stuff like that back then. I don't really need to talk a lot about the composers here. I've read, you know, included a few notes about them, and some of them are fairly interesting. What's really interesting is this stuff goes way, way, way back, you know, like 400 or 500 years, and these guys were still just as important to their peeps as we are to ours, you know. So it's kind of it brings it home, you know. We listen to this music and you go, oh yeah, like old school, you know, or like, you know, there's the classics, and we put them in their own category, and we don't think about it much beyond that. But these people, like, had lives, you know, and they struggled just like artists do today, you know, and they provided great solace for people in a very troubled time. So, you know, it's kind of fun to dig into their lives a little bit and to see what was ticking, you know, during those times. Wasn't easy back then. You know, it's not easy now, but it was really hard back in those days. So this is from 1710, Santiago de Murcia. Fantasias. These are really sweet too. Again, not to talk a lot about them, but they are what the title implies. They're very fanciful. Enjoy. Thank you. It's okay, okay, thank you. It's floaty, very floaty music. A lot of these pieces kind of roll right in one into the other. So yeah, it's okay. And they're all relatively short. So save it. Yes.
Does this help you if we clap after each one?
No, it's up to you. You know, if you feel moved to do so, by all means.
I feel very appreciative.
But if you, you know, it's okay. Like I said, they're relatively short pieces, and they sometimes flow one into the next, so it's okay. Sometimes it's better not to break the flow and the segue. So yeah, whatever you feel comfortable with. Thank you, though. These are three Bach preludes. I love Bach. Bach never really wrote anything for the guitar, although he did write some lute suites, which translates very nicely. I've selected three tonight, three preludes, one for violin, one for cello, and one for a keyboard. And I want to switch the order of the last two. I'd like to do the cello prelude last and then the keyboard one second from the well-tempered clavier. So the first one for violin goes way back for me. It's one of my first pieces. And I shouldn't say that because I'll probably goof it. In any event, I've been doing it for a very long time and I still like it very, very much. The D minor prelude. It's some call it the little prelude. So I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
I'll take just a short break if you don't mind, thanks. And get up, stretch around a little bit, or walk around, talk around, and yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Please stick around, and if you have to leave, tell somebody. Tell 2-3 people. Come. In the second half, fill the great Spanish music. This next group of pieces are all leaning toward the Spanish classic side, and all of these pieces were written for the guitar. So with that in mind, they kind of really bring out a lot of the characteristics of the instrument that can't quite be done on any other instrument, and which is nice because the guitar is it's a very human instrument, I think, and it has the capability of speaking a lot of different emotions, when you get past the bumps and humps of learning how to read the dots on the page and put them under your fingers and make them into musical notes, then you get to interpret what the composers may have experienced when they were writing this music. And at that point, you start to tap into what I consider the emotional palette, the emotional color palette. And each piece is like a fresh painting, or fresh blank canvas, really. And the composer has said, paint me this, and I have my emotional palette, and I draw my colors. So that's kind of what these Spanish classics are about. And I'll be starting somewhat slower and then building into kind of a dull roar, as it were. So bear with me. If it seems kind of lazy and floating, that's fine. You're welcome to kick back, and if you doze off, that's fine too. Bear in mind, I am recording the concert, so if you do snore, it will be on the recording. If you don't want that to happen, ask your neighbor to give you a little.
Are you going to be playing in Spanish or English?
I'm going to be playing in Spanish, but I have an interpreter if you like. Yolanda? Okay. But thank you for asking. That's an important point. This is El Testamento de Emilia, which is Emilia's testimony. Thank you. was Madronas by Federico Moreno Torroba.
Never heard of it.
Yeah, Torroba, he's big. He's big. You need to bone up on your Spanish classics, Jim.
How many years ago?
early, mid 20th century, 1950s, thereabouts, 60s, 50s, 60s.
Nice stuff.
Yeah, mid century. Oh no, that was the Villalobos. I'm sorry, that was the prelude. That was prelude number 11. Yeah, that was early 20th century in Brazil. He's Brazilian, Villalobos.
Wow.
Yeah, the next one is Madronos. This is Spanish. Yeah, by Moreno Torroba. That's the guy.
What year were those folk tunes written?
Hmm?
The Catalonian folk tunes. The
Catalonian folk tunes. I don't know. They're like they're just folk tunes, you know. I don't know. Woman's Home on the Range. I don't know. I don't know. I'm sorry. It's a melody probably, you know, carried from like way, way back. You know, been morphed through different things. So here's Madronos. I really like this one. This one's been a devil for me in a couple of concerts. So it's got a little few twists and turns in it, and so. I try to keep my cool here.
Thank you.
The legend. The legend. You will when you leave here.
I got that one.
That's all you'll speak. And Los Trigales means in the wheat fields. This is by Rodrigo, who's famous for having written the Concierto de Aranjuez, which is a very famous guitar and orchestra concerto. Last you switched around a little bit. That's okay though. So I'd like to close this set out with a really dark, dark, nice, deep piece by Emmanuel de Falla. It's an homage to Debussy, whom I also like very much. Thanks for coming. See you later. Okay. Tell someone, come down. Another half an hour to go. Thank you. In any event, I don't hear a lot of Debussy in this, but I do hear a lot of really cool Spanish guitar music, so I hope you like it. And maybe I'm not digging deep enough to find the Debussy, but I really, if you do, by all means, latch onto that and run with it. So this is the Omaggio for Chitara, for Claude Debussy. Thank you very much. 5 minutes. Finish up the program. Thanks. So this last segment of material is what I refer to as Sunday evening music. Not so much the first couple of things. They're a little more ethnic. But I think that Sunday evening music is an interesting concept. Sunday evenings are an interesting concept. We all have our own sense of what that is, but we experience one every week. And I know for me, when I was a kid, Sunday evenings were always a little melancholy. And maybe it was because I was dreading another school week starting Monday morning. And didn't want to go to bed early and didn't want to say goodbye to the Saturday and Sunday day. And but there always seemed to be music that associated itself with Sunday evenings. And this is a Sunday evening, and I was speaking to my sweetheart Yolanda a couple of months ago about this. I was working on a piece by Baden Powell that's included in this program, and I thought, wow, what a deep, dark Sunday evening piece this is, you know? And I thought, what a nice, you know, what a cool concept to put a program together of all music that represents Sunday evening, for me, anyway. And I don't know how that plays out for any of you, but this is my interpretation of Sunday evening music. So, again, the first couple of things are some very sweet pieces from the Far East, and I really like them. The middle one, of course, you know, Japanese Water Garden could be interpreted as that. But then beyond that, when we get into the Jumnopede and Valsanom and closer into the end, I think you'll see what I mean, and you know, maybe you'll latch onto that Sunday evening feel too. I don't know the title of this first one. Somebody interpreted it for me, but I don't know if it's correct or not. It's just written in Chinese characters, and I don't read Chinese. So. Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Truly, truly a Sunday evening piece. It's Baden Powell. This is one of the newest things in my collection of works, too, and this is kind of what inspired this whole program here. So I hope you like this one. This is a real nice one. Thank you. I'd like to finish the program this evening with a piece of music that's very special to me in a lot of ways. This is a piece called Classical Gas, and some of you may know it if you're of my generation. You certainly will. And it's a really great piece of music for guitar and orchestra. It's a pop tune. It took 3 Grammys in 1967. It was written by a man called Mason Williams, who was also a comedy writer for a few television series programs, the Smothers Brothers Comedy Hour, the Glenn Campbell Show, a couple of years on Saturday Night Live. So he's a kind of a, you know, big shot. In any event, Mason and I met a number of years ago on a musical project, and we recorded several CDs together and produced a music book over a 10-year period, and it was quite an experience for me. And we forged a very fine friendship over the years. So I've been doing this piece of music since I was in 8th grade, I think. I had some semblance of it. That's when I first heard it. Oh boy, I'm dating myself. I think it was 8th grade. And in the band room, of all places, playing over the loudspeakers, and I go, what is this thing? So anyway, I'm going to play it for you tonight, but I've been doing it all my life in one fashion or another. So tonight I'd like to present it to you in its full glory. I've recorded it twice now, once with chamber orchestra and once with full orchestra. And the last time I recorded it in 90-something, I think it was a 2002 release, I took a track that didn't have the guitar part in it, just the orchestration, and kept that for things just like this. So I'll be playing the piece of music, of course the intros, solo guitar, and then the orchestra comes in. So don't be surprised when you hear an orchestra but don't see it. Okay. It's here, it's really here, and I really did record it, and so it's all my direction, and you know, all of the recording work and so on, so it kind of is me anyway. I just don't play everything. Okay. Thank you. true Sunday night classic here. This movie never really played except on Sunday nights, if I recall, as a kid, and it was a very special thing, and I'm sure you'll all recognize this particular one. If this is really a Sunday night piece.
Thank you very much once again for coming out.